Hallelujah.
Assalamu alaikum, people of Syria. Now, this is my second discussion and speech with you about our demonstrations of the Syrian people outside the Chinese embassy in front of the Royal Institute of British Architects. As you know, China is really playing a very unpopular role at the moment in the world, is still supporting the Syrian regime, and they may be planning to use the veto, and they're allowing the Syrian army to use Chinese weapons, and the Arab world want to boycott the Chinese products, and you know, in Syria the donkeys are being killed and being slaughtered, and the children are being kidnapped and slaughtered. Even in their own schools, their parents are being beaten up. In the Syrian schools, the parents of the children who go to schools, their parents are beaten up, and the women are being raped. In Homs, there is a witness or many witnesses that the Shabiha, 18 Shabiha, they raped 12 women and they killed every one every other day. It was on Al Jazeera and Al Arabiya 5 days ago or 3 days ago. And he mentioned even his name. You can go to the archive of Al Arabiya and Al Jazeera. He's from Homs, and he said in some of the farms outside Homs, these rapes and massacres happening. The other thing is that women are being kidnapped from their houses and burned and thrown in the sea, and men as well. And the pillars, the minarets of the mosque, what kind of problems they cause to the Syrian regime? Why are they being demolished? Why are they being destroyed? Even the Israeli soldiers did not destroy minarets in Palestine. And the Syrian army is destroying minarets in Syria. We want the help of the Muslim world and the Christian world, because even Christians are being kidnapped and attacked because they are against Bashar al-Assad. In Syria, we have groups of suppressors from all types of religions against the people who are oppressed from all kinds of religions. So there are the transgressions, the people who are transgressive against the people who are poor and starving and have no rights from all types of religions. So really, there is no religious issues in Syria. It's between one powerful family, Al-Assad family, and Makhlouf family, who collect billions and billions from the Syrian economy. Rifat al-Assad in 1 year in the 80s collected 30 billion pounds, and he smuggled them out of Syria, and he bought Eurotunnel channel, and you can go check the accounts and company house. So the Syrian economy is suffering. The Syrian people are suffering. We want the help of international organizations, RSPCA, and the children rights, and women's rights, and the feminists, and all women organizations to write letters to the United Nations asking China and Russia stop supplying the Syrian army with weapons, and asking other countries like Iran as well and Hezbollah to stop supplying. There are Iranian soldiers and Hezbollah soldiers in Syria. They have beards, are fighting in the Syrian army. In the Syrian army, the beard is not allowed, but they brought people from Iran with a beard, and they brought people from Hezbollah with a beard, and they're fighting the Syrian people. Syria is occupied at the moment by Iranian army and Hezbollah army from Lebanon. So please help the Syrian people and open your eyes and ask China and ask Russia to stop supporting the Syrian regime by sending them weapons. Please, women organizations, children organizations, animal organizations, animal welfare organizations, please send letters and send your request to the United Nations and other countries and ambassadors in the world, asking them to support the Syrian people and allow free press and allow monitors from the United Nations to speak and interview demonstrators. And thank you so much for helping the Syrian people. And assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.